welcome to the show. You're still watching Urban Television, and we're right here on Living with a young gentleman called Valentino, who started off at the age of 13. I can see you already in the mood of dancing. Nyemuka, dance up, stand up. I don't know how to dance.
You know that's everyone's favorite.
Like a turning around part.
Yes, when we spin you around,
so
and then
exciting.
Your dresses are like.
That is so,
everyone gets crazy.
You've gotten me back in the mood. Now exactly what we have done is exactly what we're going to be talking about.
Okay,
dance. You know. Now, you started off at the age of 13. Let's talk about the first gig you got. How you hustled? Was it hard? You know, you're young, you're talented, and you're out in the world where you don't know, you have probably no connections. How did you make it?
Well, actually, my first gig I got was, it was on a fashion show. Yes, and that my first gig I got, they weren't paying me. You understand? But I did it, and there was some Indian guy that saw me, and he was like, I think these people are talented. So he got me to a gig that they paid me 500,000 to perform. So this guy like went with me and was like, I'm giving you this guy to perform on your event. That was a People's Choice Awards. Yes, I'm giving you this guy to perform for you, but you need to pay him good money. So that was a good, like for a start, because I wasn't like, you know, I was just starting up. I didn't know how the whole thing runs, but here I am today.
That is beautiful. Now, from that, you got your 500,000 and you were able, that is a lot of money. When you think about it now, that was some good money.
Yeah, that was some.
So slowly you started to be exposed, people got to know who you were. You understand, then you joined ballroom dancing, and then you started, you do contemporary a little bit, but then you start focus more into the Latino. Now, this is a question that I pose to you. How, why did you focus into this international kind of dances? What happened to our African, you know, Maganda? Like, we have our very own Flavia who works on Look at This. She's a dancer, by the way. She has her own contemporary beat and what, you know, culture dance troupe thing. Why didn't you focus more on our African thing? Because it makes money. There are so many ceremonies that people could call you on. Emikolo, Kwandula. Why did you focus in this unknown, you ventured into the unknown world?
Well, I think all my life I've always wanted, like, the unique bit of it. I love the, like, you stand out. I don't always love going for the normal, you know? Like, everyone here does Maganda and whatever. So imagine I'm going to be the next big thing in Africa.
Wow.
Doing Latin, the best Latin dance in Africa.
Speaking of Africa, how many people are into this Latin and ballroom kind of dance?
Professionally in Africa, I don't know the number. Yeah, but people are really trying out. Yes, it's this dance is very virgin in Africa. And but it's soon getting there, because like there are so many places that are being opened doing Latin dancing. There are so many, I've seen so many performances. Yeah, we just need to like polish our dancing and...
That's beautiful. Now speaking of dancing, you know, I work with people who are, for example, shout outs to Ivash. RS, he is a videographer, like he does videos and stuff like that. But he can tell a story. He can tell you, someone can come up and tell him, I want you to make it seem like there's a robbery, or I'm going through a heartbreak, and someone will act like that. Now, how do you speak through dance? Because there's someone young out there who's looking at you and is like, I'm a dancer. But how do you express yourself? Let's say I want to express myself that I'm heartbroken. How do you do it through dance?
Well, it's the body language. These are like our bodies. There's so much you can do with your body. Yeah, some people are like really so comfortable with whatever they have, but your body can really explore on a lot of things. It's your body language. You use, because when you're dancing, you use your entire body, you know? When your face speaks a lot.
In fact,
most of, I've watched most of the dancers, they ignore the facial expressions, but it's very, very important. Facial expressions, you know, like it's mainly the body. You just need to discover yourself, you know, have,
Your body, you can dance in an intimidated way, or you can dance like a heartbroken person, or you can dance like a person who's filled with joy through body. So what?
You click?
No, in a drama. Yeah. Let's do it again. Come on.
Yeah, dance. Okay, dance is, you know, like, dance is the movement of the body. I can still do even just my hands like this, and I'm dancing. You know, it's not a lot of things. You just need to, okay, it's a lot of things, but each story you tell, you learn the story. How best can I tell that I'm heartbroken? Because some people, we have some people that cannot really do so much of the facials, but just the body, you know, like maybe holding and whatever. So it's just simply the body movement. Yes.
So you master that and you can. Now.
Yeah, and also another thing, this happens when you give attention to your, like every day. If you're an aspiring dancer, make sure that at least every day you give time for just yourself to discover your body, like, how best can I go this? How best can I do this? You know, it's discovery of the body, because,
well,
everything
it
lies.
Time. It sounds like,
yeah,
it takes time. Mm-hmm. Now let's talk about. Let's go back to the journey. You know, and how you started. Yeah. You already talked about how you made your first money. This Indian man helped you push you out. But there's a young man out there or a young lady out there who's like, where do I go? How do I start off? Because now for you, I should say it was luck. You know, you know, there are some things that are written. God has written it for you. Valentino is going to be a dancer. Boom, pow, you hit it, and then that's it. But are there avenues? Are there different places where young, talented children out there can start off? Do they have to start off with a fee? Is there a dancing class in Uganda, like Batandi Kidawa?
Okay, first of all, I would say to every young person out there, they need to first seek God for guidance. I'm a pastor, by the way.
Oh, yeah, amen. So I'm down, also a hajjat. Me, I'm a Muslim, but we are still
okay, now,
everyone's religion.
Yes. No, the thing is, actually, I don't believe in luck.
Hard work.
The thing is, you need to prepare yourself. Once a chance comes, you never know when your chance is coming. I'm telling you, you never know. Because, like, when I was doing Rema's video, like, I was called and I was like, Valentino, you need it on a video shoot. You know, and I was like, okay, like the normal videos, you go and dance, and at the end of the day, the editor cuts you out and they just show your feet and whatever. Yeah. But I was surprised when the video was premiered. I was like, okay, so now she gave me a shot,
yeah,
and everyone is buzzing about that. People are calling me now. I'm getting gigs because of the video. So I never knew that this was gonna be my chance, you know. So it's preparedness preparedness meeting a chance. A chance comes and you're prepared. So I think
constantly
prepared. Yeah, you just need to be prepared all the time. If you want to be a dancer, work on your body, work on yourself. And another thing is, make as many friends and create. What has helped me so much is creating. You know, I sit all the time and I create concepts. I develop concepts and I work on them. And I shoot maybe videos with my phone, yes. And this time, these days, social media is very, very helpful.
Social media has helped
you. Yeah, social media,
yes.
Yes. So you shoot a video on
your
phone.
How many days do you practice? Do you practice like every day? Do
yeah.
you wait for for an opportunity or for you? You're like, every week, I practice thrice a week,
yeah,
and I don't care whether it's to this or that, because you never know when it's coming up.
I'm actually supposed to rehearse every day. I must have like so many hours every day to work on myself. But just because of different commitments, because I'm an actor too, I find myself like, you know, just programming myself like, this week I have this and that and that and that. So I have these hours for my rehearsals.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, one more question. Are you a family man? Are you planning to be a family man? Are you in a relationship? Because
yes.
Also there are people out there who want to either date you or, you know.
I have a very beautiful Norwegian girlfriend.
Oh, she had to be a Mzungu. Let me tell you, there's something about Rastas. There's something about people who do those things of like arts, or they do like Norwegian or something, dances. You know, things that are more inclined to attract the white people. I knew it had to be a white woman. No offense.
So, yeah,
I'm not racist, but I knew it.
Okay, how did you know that? Oh, by the way, before I forget, when they called me in the morning and they reminded me of this interview, I was like, okay, so I'm going to meet Anisha. I'm like, I go into my mirror and I'm like, okay, I rehearse my lines. So I'm going to tell her this and this and this. And man, when I reached here,
again,
I was going to throw some lines.
please. That is not true. You know the you're not even a hard. You see, I like this. But you know, the beauty about one-on-one is that we do it. It's a free-flowing conversation. It's not the ordinary. It's not what you're going to get
up. Thank you so much for having me here.
Thank you very much for coming. And don't forget, you guys, on the 18th, we're having something absolutely amazing. And it's going to feature the, what did you call them again? Not the disabled.
The different disabled persons, you know? Yes, the lame, the deaf, the blind, they come together and dance. You know, it's going to be a very great day. Saturday 18th and the National Theatre, it's an open ticket. Any amount you have, no minimum, no maximum. And another thing is the performances, the whole event starts at 2 p.m. There is social hour, learning sign language and whatever, and the performances start at 5 until 8.
So tell me, is this like your, are these your bundles of joy? Did you wake up in the morning and meet these children, or you're like, you went out for a show and you're like, how they were singled you out. You're like, this gentleman is talented, and so is this girl. Oh, you have, or do you to Gamba, you have a charity work you're working on.
Oh, okay. This is a concept from a young man called Desire. I just joined his team 2 years ago. And the thing is, he was working with them, so I found them already on the way. So right now, I'm working with the Kampala School of Physically Handicapped. They're lame. What did I say? That's what's up. So I joined Desire. You know, it's his concept. He's from Utah Convict. Yes, and these people are so amazing. It's not even about the talent, but their ability to express what they feel through the body language.
Like you know? Like you showed us a few things here.
The body language.
So it's safe to say that dance is so related, so much related to the acting world. That's why you easily flow. Because with dancing, you're acting. And with acting, you can dance.
It's actually not acting. It's living. I don't believe acting is acting.
Tell me about that. What does that even
mean? Acting is not acting. Acting is living somebody's life.
Getting into character.
That's the problem people think, that acting is acting. That's why we have so many acting in Ugandan movies. It's living someone's life.
Someone else's life. And then you start to be like the person. But if you start to act like a person, that's when you can tell on acting.
Yes, you know, because it comes from the heart. It needs to come from the heart. It needs to live in you before you bring it out. Wow. It's like my dancing, you know. I dance with Sarah and people are like, are you guys dating?
I'm surprised that the Kampala sign did not get you or put you out or put you on the front page. Because the way you people dance, the attraction, what you people displayed out was like, wow, these two are hitting it.
Yes.
And there's no way you can convince me. I don't even know, how is your Norwegian girlfriend comfortable after seeing that video?
Well, I think she, by the way, she's my number one fan. She's my number one fan, very supportive. And another thing is, I've ever performed with her once. Yes, she asked me, Val, please, can we go and perform? So I taught her to dance. She's not a dancer. But what were we saying? What were we talking about?
When love is over, you forget about it. She asked you to perform with her, and then you taught her to dance. And then
yes,
you did it.
Why, how does it happen? Like we dance and we're not related or something. It's a professional bit of it. I think I will never.
You have never been. Just don't tell. Haven't you ever had a crush on Sarah? Not even a single bit.
Well, we are best friends and we respect each
please.
Other.
You know? Can that should be a question. Can men and women be best friends without any sexual incline to anything, without any attraction, without someone saying, maybe this Saturday we can do something? That is not true.
I think we shall rehearse for that and maybe nzijen kuriimbe.
But it was lovely having a good time with you. I actually enjoyed this. You should come back again.
Guys, thank you so much. You didn't ask me. These people need to follow me.
Social media, please.
Yes, Kabenge Richard Valentino on my
Facebook. Kabenge Siwatan.
Yes, Kabenge, Kabenge Richard Valentino and RichVal7 on Instagram. RichVal7. Because I have very many projects coming up and coming very soon. Thank you so much for watching Urban TV. And Anisha here, oh my God, it's been really amazing.
It's been a pleasure.
Yeah, producers and everyone, please, thank you so much, my people. You know, when you're starting up with the arts, so many people think it's a joke. So there are those people who really follow you from day one. Man, there are some people that have been there for me, believed in me from day one. You are the best. Thank you so much, Living, for hosting me.
Thank you.
Can you please peck?
I don't. It's haram. But next time. That is all we had for you. Bye-bye.